So we're heading out to this abbey, and I don't know its name, and I know nothing about the history, but I've got to tell you, for some reason, I keep seeing, obviously French, but soldiers. French soldiers, or whoever these monks were, maybe had a cache of weapons at the abbey, and they were maybe mercenaries or secret soldiers, or maybe they're connected to like the Knights Templar. I don't know anyone else who would be men of the cloth who would have weapons, but I'm just recording it now, so we'll see what happens. I keep seeing like not Shaolin monks exactly, but like French men of the cloth, like mercenaries, or they had weapons and they knew how to fight. That's all I can say. Maybe they were masters in the art of feng shui like me.
Oh, cool.
It's called Rievaulx Abbey, because I asked the man, look at these, aren't they cool? Look, I said I want that pillow. That's my pillow. Oh my God, it's inspiring me. That's a nice way to recycle horn. It's inspiring me because I want to make my own ports and beer. Wow. It's bigger than, go away. It's bigger than Roach Abbey. I keep seeing what monks have. Did British monks or French? Were they Cistercian maybe? I could see them picking up a weapon. Oh, look. It's a station. Dedicated their lives to this God, the community comprised choir monks who spent a large part church, a new type of monk called lay brothers who worked the land. Recruits of the highest caliber. I'm going to have to look up to see whether part of that service was picking up weapons, because I'm telling you, I can see weapons. It's absolutely gorgeous. So the home of piety and peace, the abode of perfect love of God and neighbour. So watch this space. All I can hear is that song, going underground, going underground. Bird? Jackdaw? Mr. Jackdaw, tell me what I'm seeing, because I know what I'm seeing. Can you look it up on the interwebs?
What?
Can you look up on your phone to see whether they had mercenaries here? anything to do with soldiers, weapons, hiding French soldiers. Pause. So I'm reading this, and this would give the impression that there is a battle here. What's the suppression of the monasteries? I need to look that up. Watch this space. See, there's the talk of the suppression. I wonder what the suppression is. Maybe they had to fight to defend the abbey. Look. Affected by warfare between England and Scotland, pillaged by the Scots, the Black Death. Oh, God. Probably wiped out trouble because the ex is Scottish and his last name's Black. So I wonder if they had to pick up weapons to fight them, to fight for their abbey. I'm telling you, I'm about to uncover something. See, look. I wonder if they had to pick up weapons to fight, or they had to fight. Here's a little telly thing. Oh my God, there was a battle here. Oh my God. I can't believe it. Absolutely good. They would have made their own mead, possibly. I can smell beer. It's so cool. It smells like a honey mead. Because that's what they drank instead of water, wasn't it? So, I can smell it. It's like it's fermenting or something because it's warm on my nostrils. Oh, you know, like bees in a hive. On feast days, you might see the church crowded with brethren, like bees in a hive. So they did have a jolly old knees up then. Look, that's what it looked like back then. This is what it looks like now. That's awesome. Look. Bread and ale were also staples. I think it was honey mead. And the reason why I say that is because I could smell it, but like, you know, when it's in the fermenting process, because it was still very warm. I knew it. Yay! It's absolutely gorgeous. Look at those flowers. Life goes where love grows. I knew I could smell it. Tell you something else as well. I think there's some bodies buried here. There might be a little cemetery somewhere. But I can feel the dead rising to greet me.
stairs to the dormitory. Don't know if you're allowed to go down there though. I don't want to get arrested. I'm a rebel, but I'm not mean. Wow. Oh, the bird's nesting. Swiss. They played games. Chess and stuff. Connected to this place for sure. What a lovely surprise. Oh god, I'm gonna get lost. Would that be the the grapes? What did I just say? That concludes the mysteries inside histories. Oh my god. I love it. My passing shot. Listen to the birds. I think they feel the need to protect me because it was a Scottish invasion and I've come up in a car full of Scotsmen. I'm Scottish too though, so, but I'm also English, so. But all joking aside, it is actually because of me having to come here and time jump. Because I'm really protected now. I have to be real careful of who's around my frequency. So I've gotten protection from the clouds. And like there's Mother Sun up there to protect me on my jumps. Because I'm trying to prove to people that time jumping is real. And that when you read the energy and frequency around you, it completely changes the way you see the paranormal world. Death is just time suspended, but it's only suspended in memory, never in existence. Because in existence, life goes on. So, is that right, Mr. Crow? So I'm going to end it now. Thank you very much for watching and enjoy.